Hi, welcome back to the Arcade Repair Tips video series. Today we're going to talk about how to check and maybe replace a standard switching power supply. First thing we're going to do is we have a Big Bug Hunter game here and we're having some video issues, so before we do any kind of board or monitor repairs or go into detail on that, we want to make sure that the power supply is working and doing its job. Without the power to the and the right voltages going to your boards, then you're not going to get the game working right, good pictures, a lot of different problems that can cause. If we ever buy a used game, we go to auction or whatever, first thing we're going to do, a lot of times, even for right now, I got the motherboard unplugged, I got the monitor unplugged, before we go into any of that, we want to check and make sure that the power supply is working. A lot of you have probably posted or said, hey, my game's giving me, a lot of guys said, hey, check the voltage. What are they talking about? Well, what they're talking about is you basically have your wire that goes into your game, and then it goes around. This is AC, alternating current, which goes all throughout your house. In other words, it alternates everywhere. What we're going to do is this is a switching power supply, which switches that AC or alternating current to direct current. In other words, goes straight to a certain thing and does a certain function. It's also, we have a lot of voltage coming in, maybe some small voltage going out. Most of your games run on 5 and 12 volts, also some negative 5, so it's not a lot of things you got to know. You just got to know what to check and when to check them. So first thing we want to do is you've all purchased your meter and you got that ready. We're going to put it on AC. Mine, we're looking for your common voltage coming from your house, around 110 to 130. 120 is about what I like, perfect. But as long as it's 110, you start getting over 130, be careful, okay? So make sure that the AC voltage coming in is fine. And on our power supply, it's labeled for me, and most of them conveniently are. If you're not sure, follow the wires back to what comes straight off of here. Generally on a wire going in, you're going to have a black wire, which is your hot, a white wire, which is your line, or your neutral, I'm sorry, and then a green wire, which is your ground. We want to really make sure that your game is always grounded. So look at the plug. You know, when you get a game and you buy one, look at your plug. Make sure that this long pin, the straight pin, the ground pin, if it doesn't have one, throw that cord out and either replace it with another cord or go and get an end and make sure that ground. Check all your games. Make sure. I know people say, well, I plug mine in, it works fine. Don't play around without stuff being grounded. I notice a lot of times at work we'll have people that they'll experience a mild shock sometimes when a game is not grounded on the coin door. So make sure that your game is grounded. So what we're going to check is you have the two AC coming in, and then you have the FG, or your ground. So what we want to do is put the two leads, we've got our meter turned on to AC, put it on the two ACs. As you can see, we have 133 volts coming in. A little high, but I think we'll be okay today. Now what we want to do is switch it to DC. And remember, we're only looking for 12 and 5 volts, so you don't have to have it up on. My DC gives me a choice between 220 and 200. I'm going to put mine on the 20 right here. Now what you want to do is put the black lead on the ground. There says ground on here. And then the red lead on either your 5 volts, which is here on my power supply, or over here on your 12 volts. You'll notice that my 5 volts is about 5.23, which is okay, but it needs to be a little lower. So while holding them down, I'm going to turn this knob up here. Sometimes you have to use a flathead screwdriver or something. This one's convenient where you can turn it by hand. I'm going to turn that down. Okay? And then I'm going to check the 12 volts. 11.41. Ideally, you want to get as close to 5.00 and as close to 12. I have mine turned all the way down. I'm still running 5.23, and my 12 volts is only 11.4. Those are probably acceptable ranges, but hey, that's we can get a lot closer than that. So maybe it's about time to replace this power supply. Here's a brand new one. All I'm going to do is unscrew these screws, unscrew those wires, and put the wires where these were, and screw them in. It's pretty simple. But if you don't have, if you don't know where the wires go, it's pretty much labeled for you. You got the AC line, which will be your black wire, or your AC neutral. It's your white wire. This symbol right here is a symbol for ground, or a lot of times it'll have a FG or a big G or something like that. That's your green wire. All those come, and then you have your negative 5, your plus 12. A lot of times instead of the word ground, you'll see the word CON, or stands for common. So you want to make sure and put the black wires or your common wires. Those come straight off your JAMA harness or from your, look up your pinouts, and you can get those there. Then here's your plus 5, which a lot of times is a red wire. Don't go by wire colors, though. Go by where they go on your harness. If you're not sure, email and ask us, and we'll tell you how to do that. Maybe we'll do another video on that one day. So you basically unscrew these, put the wires in, screw them back down. If you have any questions, though, be sure and email us. Now, some of you might say, well, my power supply doesn't look anything like this. A lot of games now have these type, or the ATX, or, you know, sometimes I'll say computer style, even though this would be a really big one for a computer. But they kind of look like one that you've seen in a PC. These are really good power supplies. A lot of the newer style games have them. They're a little higher amperage and stuff. Personally, on the multicades and stuff, transferring a Pac-Man over to a switcher, I prefer this style. They're a little smaller, easier to get in and all that stuff, but these are okay. It's not really that big a difference in them, except for, you know, for some of the 25-inch monitors, things like that. You'll see this style in there. Basically, you got your power cord that comes in, and then you got this big Molex cord coming out with red wires, black wires, yellow wire, and a white wire. Well, all you do to check the voltage is to put it on DC, put your black wire in where the black wires are, and put your red wire where one of the red wires is. That should be your 5 volts. Then the white wire should be your negative 5, and the yellow wire should be your 12 volts. Now, if they're not put in the right place, or for some reason your wiring is different, just keep that in mind. Whatever you plug into here, though, if your red wire is showing 12 volts, make sure that's going to the 12 volts on your board. Anyway, this is just kind of a basic overview, guys. I know you might have some questions, so by all means, email and be sure and ask us. And we hope you've enjoyed this, and we'll talk to you more again soon.